Good evening. I am Evangelist Dorothy Nichols. My ministry is Community Ministry of Fort Wayne Incorporated. And this taping is event is made possible by Access Fort Wayne. Mr. Hadley is our director for the evening. And yours truly, myself, I am here. I am the producer of this program for today. I thank the pastor for allowing us to be here in the Church of Changing Lives Ministry. I'm grateful for the opportunity to be here and for us to express ourselves about how we feel about our calling. And before we go forth, we're going to ask Pastor Glenda to give us a prayer.
Let's pray. Our Father, in the name of your Son, Jesus, we thank you for who you are in our lives. We thank you for being an awesome and a great God. We thank you for being God Almighty. We thank you for being our shepherd, the great shepherd. We thank you for being the great I am.
Yes.
We thank you, Father, for being our friend.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Thank you,
we thank you for being our Redeemer.
Yes.
We thank you for being our Savior.
Yes.
We thank you for being the forgiver of our sins.
Yes.
We thank you for not giving up on us.
Thank
and
you.
We bless your name, God.
Yes.
We thank you for this gathering.
Thank you.
We thank you, Father, for the visionary, God.
Yes.
We bless your name, God, that as others hear and see, that their hearts will be touched and their lives change. We ask God that our lives, our testimonies will make a difference in this community,
Lord.
That someone will be encouraged and inspired to obey you and to follow your voice, God. I humbly ask that you would bless all of the pastors in the city, God. All of the churches, Lord Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
All of your people,
yes, God,
help us to stand for righteousness and not compromise the truth.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Never bow down to evilness.
Yes.
Never, God.
Thank you, Lord.
Never, Lord. But let us always stand where the truth is being told and even us telling the truth, God.
Yes,
we ask that you would bless this time together. We give you all the honor, all the praise. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Thank you, Lord. It is so, and so it is. Amen. Amen.
Thank you, God. Minister Sheila Nichols, she's going to give us the purpose of the event.
Amen. The purpose of this event is to allow our ministerial women to express the joy of their calling. There are two events in the life of a believer that are never forgotten. The first is when you are saved, and the second is when you are called into the ministry. There may be someone out here tonight who God is calling to step out on faith into your purpose. It is our prayer that you will be encouraged by the testimonies of these mighty women of God.
Amen.
The scripture for this evening will be from Ephesians 4 and 11 through 12. And he gave some apostles and some prophets and some evangelists and some pastors and teachers for the perfecting of the saints, for the work of the ministry, and for the edifying of the body of Christ. That's the reading for tonight.
Amen.
And we're going to start with our ministers, and we got Minister Kelsall. You can tell the people a little something about who you are, what your church affiliation is, where your church is located, along with other things that you want to say about your calling and how you came into the ministry, who encouraged you, whatever that you want, would like for someone to know about your life.
Okay.
You can do that. So we'll start with Minister Kelso.
Good evening. I'm Pastor Kelso, Alice Kelso. I'm the senior pastor of Freedom Worship Center, along with my husband, Robert Kelso. Been pastoring now for 6 years. I started in the ministry probably some 30 years ago. I guess you can say I was really blessed as for my gender, if you want to say that. I was given some great opportunities under the leadership of the pastors that I was at that time. One of the late James Hall and a couple of others. But I was blessed to serve under two of my former leaders as the assistant pastor. And so I knew at an early age that God was calling me to a higher calling. But I also knew that he had to instill in me that was necessary to prepare me for this calling. And so I actually received the call to step a little higher and to become to be a pastor. Probably about 2 years before I really ventured out into the call. And so it wasn't that anyone was telling me that you should wait or giving me any kind of advice. I knew that God was calling me, but I also knew that it was going to be some struggles. And so I think I was a little hindered on stepping forward because of the challenges that I thought would be in front of me. But I found out as I began to move in the area that God would have me to go, I found out that the way had already been made for the acceptance. And so as I moved into the calling, God has given me favor again with other pastors and throughout the city. And so my suggestion is, to those of you who may be struggling, I just want to throw this out there, to those of you who may be struggling as to whether or not this is what God is really saying to you, and you know within your heart that he is calling you to a higher ministry, I'll say to you, just take that leap of faith and just walk in your calling. No matter who accepts you, who doesn't accept you, God has already made a way for you to go through those difficult days, those challenging days. And so I said to you, lady, I said to you, woman, I said to you, my sister, I said to you, obey what God is calling you to do. Ultimately, he's the one you have to answer to. And so I just want to encourage your heart to be obedient to what you are hearing. And also, I want to give you the address of our ministry. We're located at 5821 South Anthony, inside the Lead for the Blind. Our services start at Sunday school at 10 a.m., worship service at 11 a.m. Come by and just see what God is doing, and really feel the freedom that he has intended for us to feel.
Amen.
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 I think we'll go back this way, and it's just the Pastor Ann White give us her testimony.
Amen. Amen. We're going to have a testimony. Amen. Good
Amen.
Evening to everyone. Amen to all the women of the Ministry Alliance, President Pastor Linda Griffin, also to Assistant Pastor, Pastor Kelso. It's just a blessing to be here to Sister Dorothy Nichols and to our the person that's videoing. Some of you know me as one of the Blended Sisters. I am pastor of Divine Faith Baptist Church. I started out along with my husband, who was the pastor, Reverend Curtis White III. In 1984, and I had been in the ministry ever since then. And due to some, circumstances in our lives and whatsoever, God had been preparing me, I believe so, even when I stepped out in the ministry with my husband and so forth. And now, since I am in that place now, it was a struggle at first, and because of so many things, you hear so much about, women, not the Lord, not calling women as being pastors, but, you have to know for yourself. You know, you have to know for yourself if, mm-hmm. if God has called you. And like I said, I was struggling with it, and I had confirmation, you know, but I wanted to be sure, you know, mm-hmm. that this was my calling. And one day, you know, I realized, you know, that I had to just go on in. I realized the Lord was speaking to me. I prayed and, you know, and waited on God, you know, mm-hmm. to give me an answer of this is what you need to do. You know, and you know, as the scripture says, you know, that we ought to trust God in all our ways and acknowledge Him, and He will direct your path. And He directed my path. And I truly say, I want to say thank you. And as Pastor Kelso was saying, you know, you have to obey God.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
You know, if God is for you, you know, the whole world against you, you know, and He will equip you to do what you need to do. Mm-hmm. And, you know, and I can be a witness of that. You know, it's just a few of us in our congregation, mm-hmm. you know, but God is faithful.
Yes.
And He
yes.
wants us to be faithful and depend yes. and lean on Him. Mm-hmm. And I've learned that through the years that I've been pastoring for almost, I started out in 2010 when I really accept the calling in 2010. So I've been pastoring ever since, had some ups and downs, but still, God is still there. Mm-hmm. You're in the blessing business, and I thank God for just being with us. And we are located at 1433 McCulloch Street. And we just ask that if you want to stop by, you're welcome to. Our service begins at 11 o'clock morning worship, but we also have a Bible study, which is at 10 o'clock. And we just welcome you to come in, and our motto is, we will not rest till every soul is saved.
Amen.
So we got work to do.
Amen.
Amen. So
Amen.
We just solicit your prayers in all of the ministries, all the churches that stand in order in Jesus' name.
Amen. 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 Co-Pastor Glenda.
I am Co-Pastor Glenda Griffin here at Change in Lives Outreach Ministries. I serve by my husband's side, who is the senior pastor. Pastor Virgil Griffin Jr. And my calling, I accepted, it was about 35 years ago. Mm. I did not live here at the time. I lived in Muncie, Indiana, when I accepted the calling. It wasn't easy because of how I was brought up. But I thank God for now. That it doesn't matter how you're brought up. What matters is you answering mm-hmm, mm-hmm. to the voice of the Lord that tells you specifically what He wants you to do. And I knew that it was the Lord that called me by my name. Mm. And when He called my name, He gave me instructions. He said, feed my sheep. Mm. And I knew what that meant, but I struggled. I struggled with it. For about 14 years. And the same vision that God gave me when He first called me, 14 years later, He gave me that same vision. And that's what caused me to really take a bold stand and say, it doesn't matter what man may think.
Yes.
And when I say man, that's male and female.
Right.
I know what God said.
Yes.
And I will obey
Amen.
The Lord.
Yes. Amen.
And I'm still obeying the
Amen.
Lord.
Amen.
I thank God for a husband that believes that God can call who He wants to call.
Yes,
and that's why it's easy to serve
Amen.
By His side, because of the fact that He doesn't interfere with God's business
mm-hmm.
when it comes to who He desires to call. And I would just like to say to anyone that know that God has called you. You obey God.
Yes.
Man will tell you one thing, but God will give you a specific instruction.
Amen.
And that's what you follow, specific.
That's right. Amen.
My husband and I have been pastoring now for 12 years,
Amen.
And we thank God for that. When God called us to pastor, we were at our former church at Come As You Are at the time. And God sent us on a mission to South Bend, and then He brought us back, and we've been back ever since then. And we invite you to come. We know that there are a lot of churches here in Fort Wayne, but you can't have enough churches. Because there are a whole lot of people that are not saved.
Yes, yes.
And so I would just like to invite you that if you ever have an opportunity to come and just experience God with us every Sunday morning at 10 a.m. We have our Bible studies on Tuesday at 6 o'clock p.m. But you're welcome to come. If the Lord leads you this way, 3109 Warsaw Street, just stop by. But be guided by the Holy Spirit. Amen. And we will welcome you with love. So I thank God for this opportunity that Evangelist Nichols has made available to us by way of Mr. Eric Hadley. And I thank you for this opportunity. And God bless.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Hi, I'm Evangelist Norma Jean Barkas. My church is Isaiah 61 Ministries is located at the Urban League at this time under the ministry of Carolyn Fly. We thank the Lord for her, and it's a joy to be here. I thank the Lord for just calling me out. It's been a long time. I'm taking baby steps, and I thank the Lord for being here. It's a wonderful opportunity. Thank you, Eric, for your expertise. I thank the Lord for you. I thank the Lord for all these wonderful pastors here. It's a joy to be here with all of you.
Amen. Amen.
Hi, I'm Dr. Joanne Salen, the senior pastor of Light on the Hill Worship Center. We're located at 4834 Montrose Avenue. Our services are every Saturday at 4 o'clock p.m. I am a part of the Full Gospel Baptist Church Fellowship, where my bishop is none other than Joseph Walker III. I'm happy to be here today to be a part of the Women's Ministerial Alliance and to be on program to talk about what we do and who we are. And I believe God put us in a dark place as a beacon of light to help those that are lost, those that are unsaved, those that need healing, those that are sick. And so we've been in existence for, we'll soon be 4 years, and I just thank the Lord for using us. I got called into the ministry in 1999, May of 1999, and I struggled with my calling because of certain things people were saying as being a woman minister. But after going through a lot of ups and downs and illnesses and whatnot, I decided to stop and listen to God and accept my call. And I've not been ashamed of it. I'm excited about it, and I'm glad that I did, because I didn't like the hell I was going through. So I just thank God for it. And we're small in number, but the Bible says where two or three are gathered in His name, He's in the midst of it. And I can honestly say He is in the midst of it.
Yes.
And I'm so grateful that He is in the midst. And I look forward to it every Saturday at 4. I get so excited as it gets closer and closer. For what the Lord has given me to bless someone. It's a blessing to bless somebody.
Yes.
Not always on the receiving end. I love blessing folks, and I love knowing that I've actually helped somebody. Mm-hmm. You know. So I just thank God for it, and I just ask y'all to continue. Not only pray for me, but pray for all the men and women of God that are preaching and teaching the gospel. Mm-hmm. Because like they said, there's so many folks out there that are not saved. There's so many people out there that are backslidden and hurt and confused. And we're here to help. So pick one of these churches and come hear the word, you know. And if you don't like the ones, this is the city of churches. I'm sure you'll find one. Mm-hmm. But if you can't find one, come check us out and see what we have to offer in the name of Jesus. Amen. Thank you.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Hi, I'm Dr. Sandra Nolan. My church is Tabernacle Baptist Church, located 3204 Chestnut Street, where the pastor is Gonzalee Martin. I am associate minister there. My calling, I knew I was called as a child, because I come from a family of ministers, and my grandmother was a pastor, but I didn't want to be called. So I ran. I tried to make myself unworthy of the calling. I went to school. I have degrees in almost anything you can imagine. Because I felt if I stayed in school, I wouldn't have to be called. He couldn't catch me because I had to finish school. And then one day when I was sitting, it was like 12 years ago, and I live in Chicago, I was sitting on the balcony, and God spoke to me just as clearly as day and said, "When are you going to do what I asked you and called you to do?" Mm-hmm.
And I tried to think of some things to reasons why I couldn't do it right then. And God said, if not now, then when? And then I started thinking of some of my sisters and brothers that come from a large family, and I was thinking about maybe one of them could be called. And he said, if not you, then who? So then, right then, I knew I had to step into my destiny. Whether I liked it or not, I had to step in my destiny and be obedient to God. And I have been obedient. And God told me, he said, write what I tell you to write. Preach what I tell you to preach. Don't preach not one word more than I give you. And don't preach not one word less than I give you. And that's what I preach. That's all I preach. I preach Jesus. I preach salvation. I preach his love. And yes, I will preach his wrath. Because God is not only a loving God, he's a God of vengeance too. And so some people just want to know God loves you, loves you, loves you. But you step out of that zone, he'll get you, get you, get you. And so that's when I knew my calling. I'm also the president of the Women of Prayer Ministries Fort Wayne chapter, where we give out vouchers and we try to help teenagers and we try to help young adults and we try to do referrals and we try to do whatever it is that people need in this world. So you always can contact the Women of Prayer Fort Wayne at 260-409-2724. We are affiliated with the Women Ministerial Alliance as well. So if you'll get a Sunday and you want to hear the word, I advise you to come on out. Devotion starts at 11 o'clock and church starts at 11:30. And if you come to Sunday school at 9:30, in between fellowship and devotion, they have breakfast. So if you stay for breakfast and hear the word of God, again, it's located 3204 Chestnut Avenue. And my word to anyone is, God said, fear not. He told you, have no fear. He said, I am God. I have overcame the world. So if God has overcame the world and he has told you to fear not, you have nothing to be afraid of. He said, I'll be with you to the end of time. How long is time? Eternity. So I'm telling you, step out on faith. Step out. Don't be afraid. You're going to get obstacles in your way, but he still is God.
Yes, he is.
And he can do anything. So that's my word to you, is just step on out.
Amen.
The first thing I want to say today is it's such an honor to be a part of this Ministerial Alliance. You guys have been great mentors to me. I really appreciate it and I love you all. But my ministry is not a pastor. I'm a minister of Psalms. And I believe, as a little girl, I believe I was supposed to sing to everyone and anybody. I'd always stand in the mirror on my little microphone, just singing away. And then as I got older, I started singing in school plays and school talent shows. Then it branched out. After I got out of high school, I was like, what am I going to do now? Then as people knew me, and I would kind of sing in little groups and different things like that. So I started getting asked to sing at weddings and funerals and all kinds of things. And then all of a sudden, Pastor White, as she came into the ministry, she told me, well, we got our Sunday meeting on second Sunday in a month. I'm going to need you to come over and give us a selection. So as I began to grow, that kind of thrust me out there and said, okay, you know, I'll sing at weddings and funerals, so I need to do something else. So I started singing on second Sundays. Then as I was going over there, Pastor Sandlin and Evangelist Nichols said, hey, why don't you come sing over here? So that pushed me on some more. I said, okay. Then I began to sing at Evangelist Nichols, her community choir. I was like, okay. Push me some more, then Pastor Sandlin said, come on now. You know, you my songbird. Come on over here, girl. I need you to sing in my church. Come on. So as I, like, again, I say, I do believe as a little girl I was meant to sing and minister. And I can feel, you know, when I'm singing, I know that God has called me to sing.
Yes,
because
yes.
It just flows,
yes,
like, I mean, that's you it. Know what you know. You
yes,
just sing. I don't even sing with music. I just sing.
Amen.
Whatever God calls me to sing or put on my mind to sing, I just do it.
Yes.
And if you are a psalmist and you like to sing, get on out there and sing. Matter of fact, call Evangelist Nichols up. She will get you in there. Just go in and do what you got to do. She'll push you right on out there and let you do what you got to do. In Jesus' name. That's my ministry.
Who you are.
Oh, I'm Janier Majors, and I belong to Harvest Word of Faith, and my I have Bishop Howell as my minister.
Amen.
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 Amen. Well, again, I'm Evangelist Dorothy Nichols, and I'm a member of Renaissance Baptist Church under the leadership of Reverend Michael Latham. God started me out at Jerusalem Baptist Church. That's where I first joined. And after joining there, I started with the choir, and God kept elevating me from one level to the other. And I began to teach Sunday school and still going higher. I just was there in church, and I had my outside group because I love the young people, and I love working with the young people. So they had a choir, and they were learning to sing, and my agenda started not being in touch with the church as much. Sometimes I would have places to go that people would call me to bring the children to sing, and it would be a conflict sometimes with the church curriculum. And I went through a lot of changes over there because I was told, you don't need to be over there when we're doing this over here, and so forth and so on. And so I finally, I got discouraged. And I was torn between, and so many things were going on until I started staying at home and not going to church.
Mm-hmm.
And through that, I went through that, and I got to the point that I was comfortable at home on Sunday morning. Mm-hmm. And I had been in church for so long and never missed a Sunday. I always was there, rain, shine, sleet, or snow. But I just really was comfortable. And it kind of scared me, because I started saying to myself, God, am I backsliding? What is going on with me? What is happening with me? Because I was comfortable at home. And I got up, I was in my bedroom, and I got up and I went to the mirror, and I was just looking in the mirror, and a voice, God's voice, spoke to me and said, that's why you have to declare yourself an evangelist. And that broke a lot of other chains and things off of me. And I went to my pastor at Jerusalem, Reverend Walker, and I told him what God had spoke in my spirit. And he said, well, now, we don't allow no women ministers in the Baptist denomination. And I was like, okay. I didn't get upset.
Mm-hmm.
I just took it like what it is. I didn't know what I was going to do next or how it was going to go. But I started back to church and singing in the choir. And one Sunday morning, he got up over the pulpit and he said, I want Dorothy to come up here, because she say God done called her to preach. Now the rest of y'all don't come up here talk about God done called you to preach. That's what he said. And it was funny. Everybody laughed. But he gave me my license.
Amen.
He gave me, when God is for you, who can be against you?
Yes,
so that was mine. I can feel it now.
Amen.
When he
Amen.
Called me into the ministry, and I know that it was God. And then to put me in agreement with my pastor mm-hmm. that he had to go over what he had said he yes. wouldn't do mm-hmm. to do it anyway because yes. he knew mm-hmm. that had to be fulfilled and he didn't get in the way. And then later I went over mm-hmm. Reverend Michael Latham, he came out of Jerusalem also. And he had his ministry, and he asked the pastor, could I come over and help him with some of his young people? And so that's how I ended up going over to Renaissance Baptist Church and helping with the young people there. And so I still, you know, love my outside ministry. I call myself the community evangelist because I love to go. I love to support others. I just love to be free to go where God calls me to be. And so I can have that freedom now and I can be in the place that I need to be in when I need to be there. And I'm just very, very grateful for that. Very grateful. And this is my daughter. And I'm just glad that she came today, this evening, to be with us also. And we thank you for taking your time out to come and film this for us.